Hello everyone. In this video, you will learn how to solve a linear programming problem using simplex method. So let us consider a linear programming problem. So example is like this. Solve following linear programming problem using simplex method. Maximize z equal to 7x1 plus 6x2 subjected to x1 plus x2 less than or equal to 4. Then 2x1 plus x2 less than or equal to 6. Here x1 x2 are greater than or equal to 0. Here the z equation is called objective function, and our objective is to maximize value of z. These are the constraints, and this is non-negativity constraints. In previous videos, we have seen how to formulate such linear programming problem. Now for this linear programming problem, let us assume x1 is number of product of type A, x2 is number of product of type B, then z is profit equation. First constraint represents constraint on time limit of machine 1, and second constraint represents constraint on time limit of machine 2. Non-negativity constraint means number of product can be either 0 or greater than 0. There is no meaning for negative value of number of product of type A or number of product of type B. In previous videos, we have seen how to solve such linear programming problem using graphical method. Graphical method cannot be applied when number of variables involved in LPP are more than 2. Here we will see simplex method to solve the linear programming problem. In simplex method, first we need to express given linear programming problem into standard form. Now here, if you see the first constraint, x1 plus x2 is less than or equal to 4. So to convert this less than or equal to sign into equal to sign, we need to add a slack variable on left hand side of this constraint so that this less than or equal to sign can be written as equal to sign. So here we can write first constant as x1 plus x2 plus s1 is equal to 4. Similarly, for second constant also, this 2x1 plus x2 is less than or equal to 6. Here also, left hand side of this constant equation is less than right hand side of the constant equation. So, if you add a slack variable s2 on left hand side of this constant, then this less than or equal to sign can be replaced by equal to sign. So we can write 2x1 plus x2 plus s2 is equal to 6. Here the slack variables s1 and s2 are the dummy variables. Now if constant equation 1 indicates time constant for machine 1 and constant equation 2 indicates time constant for machine B, then s1 will be the idle time for machine 1 and s2 will be the idle time for machine 2. Since slack variables represent idle resources, they contribute 0 to objective function. So while writing objective function, coefficient of slack variables will be 0. So objective function can be written as maximize z is equal to 7x1 plus 6x2 plus 0s1 plus 0s2. Now similar to x1 and x2, non-negativity constraints are also applicable for slack variables s1 and s2. So we can write x1, x2, s1 and s2 are greater than or equal to 0. So this is standard form of linear programming problem. So after converting linear programming problem into standard form or normalized form, we can go for simplex table. In simplex table, first row includes coefficient of variables in the objective function. Second row includes all the variables in the problem. So first we will write all the variables included in the problem in second row, and in first row we will write coefficient of respective variables in the objective function. So first variable is x1, its coefficient in objective function is 7, for x2 coefficient is 6, for s1 it is 0, and for s2 it is 0. So we can write coefficient of respective variable in the objective function. The first row or seizure row indicates the profit or cost per unit to the objective function of each variables. Then the first column is CB column. This CB column represent coefficient of current basic variable. Then second column is basis column, which includes basic variables, or it is also called as product mix column. It represents the basic variable of the current solution. In simplex method, a start is made with feasible solution, which we shall get by assuming that profit earn is zero. So here this Z is profit equation, and if you consider x1 and x2 are zero, then profit will be zero. So here x1 and x2 are the decision variables whose values for first iteration will be zero. So here for first iteration, s1 and s2 will be the basic variables, and they form basis for next iterations. The first column CB represent the coefficient of current basic variables in the objective function. So here coefficient of s1 and s2 in the objective function are zero. So CB values for first iteration will be zero. Now in third row, we have to write the coefficient of first constant equations. So here coefficient of x1 is 1, coefficient of x2 in first constant equation is 1, coefficient of s1 is 1, s2 is not present in first constant equation, so coefficient of s2 will be 0. Then next column is the solution value column, or it is also called as quantity column, in which we have to write right hand side of constant equations value. So solution value of first constant equation is 4, so here we can write 4. Similarly, in next row, we have to write coefficient of variables in the constant equation 2. So here, coefficient of x1 is 2, coefficient of x2 is 1, s1 term is not present in second constant equation, so its coefficient will be 0, and coefficient of s2 will be 1, and solution value for second constant equation is 6. So in this way, we can prepare simplest table from given linear programming problem. Now here, this matrix, it is called body matrix or coefficient matrix, and this is identity matrix or unit matrix. It is also called as basis matrix, as s1 and s2 are the variables in the basis column. So here this s1 and s2 are the basic variables, and solution column values are the respective values of these basic variables. So here s1 is equal to 4 and s2 is equal to 6. The variables which are not present in the basis column are called non-basic variables, and its values will be 0. So here the values of x1 and x2 will be 0. So by putting values of x1 is equal to 0, x2 is equal to 0, s1 is equal to 4 and s2 is equal to 4, we can get z max is equal to 0. So this is called initial basic feasible solution. The values of variables in the initial basic feasible solution should be greater than or equal to 0. So next row is Z0. Values in Z0 can be calculated by using formula summation of product of coefficient of current basic variable and respective coefficient in that row. So to calculate first value of Z, that is Z1, we can write 0 into 1 plus 0 into 2, which is equal to 0. Similarly, second value of Z, that is Z2, can be calculated as 0 into 1 plus 0 into 1, that is equal to 0. So Z2 is equal to 0. Similarly, Z3 value can be calculated as 0 into 1 plus 0 into 0, which is equal to 0. Similarly, Z4 can be calculated as 0 into 0 plus 0 into 1 is equal to 0. So for first iteration, as both value of CB are 0, all ZJ value will be 0. Here ZJ value represent contribution lost per unit of variables, that is amount by which contribution or profit would be reduced if one unit of corresponding variables added to basis column. So if you add any of these variables in the basis column, then contribution lost to the objective function will be 0. Now next row is CJ minus ZJ. So CJ minus ZJ can be calculated by subtracting ZJ values from CJ values. So 7 minus 0, 7, 6 minus 0, 6, 0 minus 0, 0, 0 minus 0, 0. So this is CJ minus ZJ row. CJ minus ZJ row is also called as index row or net evaluation row. CJ minus ZJ determines whether current solution is optimum or not. The values in the CJ minus ZJ row indicates net increase in ZJ value if we introduce the respective variables into the solution. Means if you introduce x1 in the solution, then profit will be proportional to 7. If you introduce x2, then profit will be proportional to 6. If you introduce s1 and s2, then there will not be change in the profit. So here our objective is to maximize the profit z. So if you introduce x1 in the solution, then increase in profit will be the more. So here the maximum positive value of cj minus zj is 7. So the corresponding column will be the key column, and respective variable, that is x1 variable, will be the incoming variable in the solution. Now to decide outgoing variable out of these two basic variables, we have to calculate ratio column, that is theta. So theta or ratio column is ratio of solution column values divided by respective values in the key column. So we can calculate theta column or ratio column as 4 divided by 1 is equal to 4 and 6 divided by 2 is equal to 3. This theta value indicates the number of products that can be produced by trading all of the current basic variables. So here we have to choose the minimum positive value. So here this S2 should be outgoing variable because it indicates less number of product that can be produced as compared to S1. So we can decide Q row as the minimum positive number from the replacement ratio column. So this is the key column and this is the key row. For next iteration, this S2 will be the outgoing variable and X1 will be the incoming variable. So in next table, instead of S2, we will write X1. Element at intersection of key column and key row is called key element. In simplex method, while going for next iteration, we have to convert this key element into 1. So by dividing to this key row by key element, we can convert this key element into 1 and we can replace S2 by X1 for next iteration. So for next iteration, again we can prepare this simplex table. So here we will write x1 instead of s2, and coefficient of current basic variable in objective function, for s1 it is 0 and for x1 it is 7. Now we have to perform row operation, that is r2 is equal to r2 divided by 2. So 2 divided by 2 1, then 1 divided by 2 0.5, then 0 divided by 2 0, then 1 divided by 2 0.5, then this 6 divided by 2 it is 3. Now next step is we have to convert other element in key column into 0 by performing row operations. So here to convert this element into 0, we can write operation as r1 is equal to r1 minus r2. Now here this key element is converted into 1. So r2 element is 1. So if I write 1 minus 1, it will be converted into 0. So operation will be r1 is equal to r1 minus r2. Here this r2 is r2 new, means we have to use these values of r2 while performing this row operation. So for first element, so r1 is equal to 1 and r2 is equal to 1. So 1 minus 1 it is 0. Similarly, second element in r1 row is 1 and respect to r2 element is 0.5. So 1 minus 0.5 is 1 minus this 0.5 is equal to 0.5. So here we can add 0.5. Similarly, for third element, r1 value is 1 and respective r2 value is 0. So 1 minus 0 is equal to 1. So this value will be 1. For next element, respective r1 element is 0 and r2 element is 0.5. So 0 minus 0.5 is equal to minus 0.5. So this value will be minus 0.5. Same operation we have to perform on solution column also. So for solution column value, respective r1 element is 4 and r2 element is 3. So 4 minus 3 is equal to 1. So value in the solution column will be 1. So respective b value is 1. Now this is the updated simplex table. Now from this point onwards, we can repeat the same procedure. So again we can calculate the ZJ value. So ZJ can be calculated by using formula summation of product of CB coefficient of current basic variable into respective element in the K key respective element in the respective coefficient in that row. Respective coefficient value in the first constant equation. So Zj can be calculated by using formula summation of product of coefficient of current basic variable and respective coefficient in the and respective coefficient. Here Zj value can be calculated by using formula summation of product of coefficient of current basic variable and respective coefficient in that row. So here we can calculate Z1. So Z1 is equal to 0 into 0 plus 7 into 1 is equal to 7. Similarly, here we can calculate Z2. So Z2 is equal to 0 into 0.5 plus 7 into 0.5, which is equal to 3.5. Similarly, we can calculate Z3. So Z3 is equal to 0 into 1 plus 7 into 0, which is equal to 0. So we can write 0. Similarly, we can calculate Z4. So Z4 is equal to 0 into minus 0.5 plus 7 into 0.5, which is equal to 3.5. So Z4 is equal to 3.5. Next, we can calculate Cj minus Zj. So 7 minus 7 is 0. Then 6 minus 3.5, it is 2.5. 0 minus 0, 0. 0 minus 3.5, minus 3.5. The values in Cj minus Zj determines whether current solution is optimum or not. So here current solution is S1 is equal to 1 and X1 is equal to 3. Now here if there is positive value in Cj minus Zj row, then there is scope of improvement. So here this maximum positive value of Cj minus Zj is called P column. So here X2 will be the incoming variable. So if you introduce X2 in the solution, then there is scope for improvement. Now next we have to decide the outgoing variable. To decide, we have to calculate replacement ratio column, that is theta column. So theta is equal to B divided by key column, means value in the solution column divided by respective value in the key column. So here this 1 divided by 0.5, which is equal to 2, then this 3 divided by 0.5, which is equal to 6. So here to choose key row, we have to decide minimum positive value of this replacement ratio column. So out of this 2 and 6, minimum positive value is 2. So this row is key row. So here this is the key column and this is the key row. The value at intersection of key column and key row is called key element. And the corresponding variable in the key column, it is the incoming variable, and corresponding variable in the key row, it is the outgoing variable. So for next iteration, we have to replace this S1 by X2. At the end of second iteration, basic variables are S1 and X1. So value of S1 is 1 and value of X1 is 3. Other variables are non-basic variables and values of those non-basic variables are 0. Means values of X2 and S2 will be equal to 0. So by putting values of S1 is equal to 1, X1 is equal to 3, S2 is equal to 0 and X2 is equal to 0 in objective function Z, then we will get Z max is equal to 21. But as there is scope for improvement, we can go for next iteration. While going for next iteration, we have to replace this S1 by X2 and respective coefficient of this basic variable X2 will be 6. Similar to previous iteration, this key element we have to convert into 1. So to convert this key element into 1, we have to divide to this key row by key element. So by performing operation, R1 is equal to R1 divided by 0.5 or 2 into R1, we can convert this key element into 1. So again we can prepare the simplex table. The values in the C0 remain same as previous iterations. So here we have to replace this S1 by X2 and respective coefficient will be 6. So here this S1 will be replaced by X2. This X1 remains same and its coefficient will be 6 and 7. Now by performing this row operation, we can write for first element 2 into 0 is 0. For second element 2 into 0.5 it is 1. Then 2 into 1 it is 2. Then 2 into minus 0.5 is equal to minus 1. And same operation you have to perform on solution column also. So 2 into 1 is 2. Now in next step we have to convert other element in key column into 0 by performing row operation using key row. So here we have to convert this 0.5 into 0. And this key element is already converted into 1. So by using this key element we have to convert this 0.5 into 0. So for that we can write operation as R2 is equal to R2 minus 0.5 into R1. Here this R1 means R1 new. So while performing this row operation we have to use new value of R1 row, that is these values. So for first element we can write R2 is equal to 1 and respective R1 element is 0. So here we can write 1 minus 0.5 into 0 is equal to 1. So this element will be equal to 1. For second element respective R2 value is 0.5 and R1 value is 1. So we can write 0.5 minus this 0.5 into R1 is equal to 1. So 0.5 minus 0.5 is equal to 0. So this element will be 0. So this value should convert into 0 because we have written this row operation so that this element will convert into 0. So by performing this row operation, this value should be converted into 0. Then next R2 value is 0 and respective R1 value is 2. So 0 minus 0.5 into 2 is equal to minus 1. So this value will be minus 1. Then to calculate next value of R2, respective R2 value is 0.5 and R1 value is minus 1. So here we can write 0.5 minus 0.5 into minus 1, which is equal to 1. So this will be equal to 1. Similarly, same operation we have to perform on values in the solution column. So respective R2 value is 3 and respective R1 value is 2. So 3 minus this 0.5 into 2, which is equal to 2. So this will be equal to 2. Now similar to previous iterations, we have to calculate ZJ and CJ minus ZJ. So we can calculate ZJ values by using formula. ZJ is equal to summation of product of coefficient of current basic variable into coefficient in the respective row. So here to calculate Z1 we can write 6 into 0 plus 7 into 1, which is equal to 7. So this is equal to 7. Then to calculate Z2 we can write 6 into 1 plus 7 into 0, which is equal to 6. So Z2 is equal to 6. Then to calculate Z3 we can write 6 into 2 plus 7 into minus 1, which is equal to 5. So here we can write 5. Similarly we can calculate Z4. So Z4 is equal to 6 into minus 1 plus 7 into 1, which is equal to 1. So here we can write 1. Now we can calculate CJ minus ZJ. So 7 minus 7 is 0, 6 minus 6 is 0, 0 minus 5 minus 5, 0 minus 1 it is minus 1. Now here this CJ minus ZJ determines whether current solution is optimum or not. Now current solution is X2 is equal to 2 and X1 is equal to 2. Here all values of CJ minus ZJ are either 0 or negative. So there is no scope for improvement. If you replace these basic variables by this S1 or S2, then value of objective function will reduce proportional to respective value in CJ minus ZJ row. So there is no scope for improvement. So here we have to stop the iterations. So at the end of this third iteration, we have got value of x2 is equal to 2 and x1 is equal to 2. Here s1 and s2 becomes non-basic variables and its values are 0. So by putting values of x1 and x2 in objective function, we can get z max as 26. In first iteration, we have got z max as 0. In second iteration, z max is equal to 21. And in third iteration, we have got z value as 26 at x1 is equal to 2 and x2 is equal to 2. So this is the optimal solution. Now, the same problem we have solved in previous video by using graphical method. And here if we observe, we have calculated z values at different points. So if you consider a point, value of z is 0. If you consider this b point, value of z is 21. If you consider this c point, value of z is 26. In simplex method also, at the end of first iteration, we have got z is equal to 0, means we have got value of z at a point. Then at the end of second iteration, we have got value of z as 21, means value of z at point B. And in third iteration, we have got value of z as 26, means we have got value of z at point C. So in simplex method also, we are finding the values of objective function at corner points of the feasible region. So while going for next iteration, we are changing the corner and we are checking the value of z. Now according to simplex method, we should not proceed to point D because objective function will be less than 26. So in this way, in simplex method also, for first iteration we will get value of z at point A, in second iteration we will get value of point B, and in third iteration we will get value of z at point C. Thank you for watching.